exploring the deep sea is so exciting. It's been my dream ever since I was a little kid. I could compare it to exploring outer space, except it's right here on Earth.
Today we're off the coast of Big Sur in California, and we're on top of a mountain. It might not look like it, but underneath the ocean is a giant mountain.
As the water sweeps across the ocean floor and it comes up to this underwater mountain, it provides food and nutrients to anything that lives on this underwater mountain. And so seamounts the world over, but in particular here on Sur Ridge, are filled with gorgeous corals and sponges that get huge, 10 feet tall sometimes, and bigger than I am.
How's the weather looking?
Okay. You guys okay for lights?
Yeah, go ahead.
The purpose of our expedition today is to explore all the water that's above Sur Ridge up to the surface. And it's a particularly special body of water because animals like jellies and crustaceans and fish, they'll all congregate on top of these underwater mountains. And so we really could see some very unusual creatures today.
We're going to Sur Ridge. I've never been there before. I'm really, really excited. And I don't really know what we're gonna find. We're gonna see some crazy stuff.
Oh man.
We're really fortunate to be out with the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute, who's letting us use their resources to help find deep sea animals. The animals that we're trying to reach live much deeper than anyone can possibly scuba dive. So we need very specialized equipment to reach these animals. The ROV Doc Ricketts is a large underwater science robot that helps us get down into these habitats and find these animals. It is lowered from this big ship, the Western Flyer, down into the deep sea, and it's attached by a tether that runs up to all the monitors and controls in the control room. So we can sit up on the boat while the pilots fly the ROV through the deep sea. Every time we launch the ROV, I'm really excited to see what we see in the deep sea. Sorry.
I think it's good to stop and just look once in a while.
Here, let's look. Yeah, top right here. What do we got? Whoa.
You expect the unexpected. These animals look extremely bizarre when compared with surface creatures that maybe we're more used to seeing.
Deep sea animals have to deal with the most extreme conditions. Miles of water pressing down on them, extreme temperatures, and very little access to food. And so they have all these crazy adaptations.
Can we look at that? Let's see, what is that? Many of the animals that we're encountering in the deep sea don't have any common name. Many of them have no scientific name.
I don't know what that is.
So sometimes we see a jelly and we're like, oh, well, that looks like the Millennium Falcon. So we'll call that the Millennium Falcon jelly for now. and sometimes those names stick for a little while, but eventually they'll get a more official scientific name and perhaps another common name.
Seeing Sur Ridge definitely lived up to my expectations. I've done a lot of dives, but I didn't realize how much different it was going to look. I've never seen so many corals, such big corals and sponges and so many things. It's like visiting a rainforest or something, and the trees are corals instead of, you know, regular trees. Every little nook and cranny that we zoomed into had some kind of, it's like, oh, there's a tiny sea star and a little crab living in there, and there's just all these levels of big stuff and little stuff, and the whole thing is beautiful and complex.
The deep sea has not been explored very much at all, so most people have no idea what life is like in the deep sea, and this is our opportunity to really share that with them. I think it's one of the coolest places on the planet, and I would love for other people to think it's really cool as well.